we set out at the start of that season. That was the main goal, the main aim, to get promoted. And it all boiled down to those two games at the end of the season.
It was, I'll be honest, in the 30 odd years of supporting Newry, it's something, the expectation and the excitement around the town was something I hadn't ever felt.
You're that close between the nerves and what can be, and you're trying to not to think what could be. You're trying not to let your mind run away with you. You know, should be laying in bed at night thinking, we're not that far from the Premiership.
To sports in Newry City take on Carrick Rangers in the first leg of the promotion playoff at the Showgrounds later. Just 6 years after going out of business, City have the chance to return to the top flight of Irish League football.
I've never been as nervous at a game of football in my life. Never.
That week was, it was all, look, you go to work, that's all you think about. It was, it was a long week.
Anybody you've seen, like a lot of people you've seen, even downtown, or even I was working in Dublin, people were coming to me and saying to me, Stephen, like lads from Newry, I wouldn't see maybe on site, they would say to me, like, yeah, you're good luck on whatever it was, Friday night or whatever, like, you know, it was brilliant, like, you know, there was some atmosphere in the town at the time, like, you know.
Well, your ambition always was to get back to the Premiership, but when you're sitting without a team, essentially without a club, without players and cobbling together players at the last minute, you don't ever think it's a realistic ambition. You certainly don't think you're going to do it with four promotions in five seasons.
It was something that you sort of dreamt that this would happen, but never ever expected it. Like, you know, I think back to moving home from England and getting on the bus to watch Newry and Rich Hill and going to a public park in Portadown and thinking, you know, when will this ever feel like we're watching a club that you can support.
So you're trying not to let things run away with you, but at the same time it's very difficult not to do that. You're thinking of going to Windsor Park or the Oval or wherever it might be. So it was a whole sort of containment of emotions and making sure we didn't get carried away. You know, outwardly you might seem calm, inwardly, you know, a packet of randoms, so you're all over the show. And you're just trying to make sure at the right time everything is coming together.
Yeah, it's always good being back. A lot of feelings and emotions and that. But any time I come down, I'm always made welcome. So, yeah, good to be back. Come on, we sit over here, look. Come on over here with me. Come on.
My most enjoyable years of football, definitely. I suppose I was probably the fittest I've ever been. We had a really good team, we were winning promotions. So yeah, my most enjoyable years of football, definitely. It helped that we were winning, but there was always a good dressing room. That was a factor of good lads and winning games. But there was always a bit of banter about me being a Mexican, but that just added to it.
To be honest with you, Friday night is a big night for me because I was at a specialist one time and I was going around in circles with injuries, and without saying the words, his words were, what do you think of cycling? And basically he was saying to me that you probably need to go and find another sport. So it's not even a low point in my career, it's a low point in my life, to be honest with you. Football was everything to me, it was all I ever knew. And I remember sitting in the office with the consultant, I'll never forget him in my life. I was with my mum, and when he said that, I actually broke down. I just started crying. I didn't really know what to do. And as I say, after that, my mom helped me big time. She was always there, and dad as well, you know, and football was everything.
And what year was that you started playing again?
That would have been roughly maybe 2014, 2015. And I ended up signing with Newry in January 2016. I spent 5 years here, and at the time I wasn't thinking this last chance, but looking back now, I probably got fit at just the right time to leave a mark and have some football memories.
Look at that pitch. Cool, isn't it? Huh?
If we are to get promoted, it's everybody has different motivating factors, but I have a few different ones there. It's probably for me parents more than anything, because they've stuck by me on absolutely everything. Even as I say, I laugh at sometimes. If I had went to them and said, "Look, I'm quitting," they definitely would have laughed at me. You know, Friday night is for them more than anyone.
The message going out was, don't let ourselves down. Not to put too much pressure on us, because sometimes the weight of expectation is unfair on players. Want to go out and play how they had been throughout the season, do themselves justice.
It was unbelievable. From you walked out to do the warm up, right through, you know, there was never a sense that we were ever going to lose that game. Players knew what was happening. You know, the fans, we could sense it from the fans, they were willing us on. How do you feel? Yeah, well, saying it was a fault for the first goal, I slipped. I was playing left back that night. And slipped, and they got a cross in, scored the goal. Lucky enough, I didn't slip in the last 6 or 7 minutes. It was the first 6 or 7 minutes, so therefore we had plenty of time to get ourselves back into it. And then you go two down.
I remember being 2-0 down, and I was thinking, "Oh, fuck off." I just thought, this isn't fair. This isn't supposed to happen. Just, there's no coaching course that will ever prepare you for that. Because I was actually thinking then, because I was thinking of my dad, because I'd said loads of prayers and I went and was at his grave and I'd lit candles and everything leading up to it. And I was like, "Oh, come on, dad, pull a few strings here. You know, try and do something for us."
I suppose the biggest thing is, you go through the season, you experience the difference, highs and lows, I suppose. I don't think we had been 2-0 down that season, and then you're playing against opposition that are a little bit stronger than what we had played against.
I had it in my head that, and you know, you read about these things and you check who usually wins playoffs, and you know, whenever you're just, I guess, obsessed with Newry and football, and how often does the Championship club beat the Premiership club, and you're telling yourself that the positivity of being the team in second rather than being the team in 11th, so you're hopeful, and then 10 minutes in you're 2-0 down to the Premiership club, so it wasn't ideal, it wasn't the best start.
I was just like, there are about 3,000 people inside this ground here and we're 2-0 down after 9 minutes, you know, we're going to make an absolute balls of this. You were giving it maybe the next 10 minutes and thinking, if we don't score here, at least one, and at least get it back at 2-1 by half time, that's it.
To get that first goal back is always a big one, like, you know.
From 2-0 down, like, a lot of teams could have crumbled and it could have been over at half time, but no, the character was shown to come back, it was absolutely superb, so it was.
it was vital that we get the first one back pretty quick, which we did. You know, and I think that's probably down to an OG. It might well have been going wide and the keeper, you know, headed in.
Yeah, well, I mean, they got a bit of luck when I slipped and we messed up for the second goal. So we were due that little bit of luck, and we weren't playing badly or poorly. We just were unfortunate with the start we got. So yeah, we were due that bit of luck, I suppose. After you conceded two goals, you're thinking get one back. When you get one back, you know then there's a good opportunity to get another back. When you get two back, then you know it's game on.
Everybody's confident except Dagi when Dagi's going for a penalty. You know, the other way around, Dagi's the only person that's confident that's going up for a penalty, because you honestly don't know where it's going to go.
It wasn't a case of when he celebrated. The thing that struck with me, and even from watching back in the highlights repeatedly after that, he celebrated as if, come on, let's go and get another one. It wasn't a case of, yeah, let's celebrate it, that's a job done. I mean, bear in mind, we'd been 2-0 down after 9 minutes and we were 3-2 up just before half time. Nobody sort of criticised him that much. Nobody was that annoyed. It was disappointing, obviously. He was as disappointed as anybody else.
Oh, he killed me 10 worms, didn't he? The credit there, in fairness to him. But no, look, tell you what, he was superb that first game, so he was. So, no, we'll let him away with that one, I think.
You know, he had the strength of character to go up and take it. The second one, yeah, would have made it a wee bit more comfortable, if you like, going in. But in a way, it also meant we didn't get too complacent. You know, we needed to go one goal in there back enough.
Obviously, we've been 2-2 coming back and been 3-2 up then. When the final whistle went, you're thinking, right, this is our year now. We have a great chance. We seen what they had to offer, and we knew that we had more than what they had, and it was just about going out and finishing the job then. But yeah, as you say, it was only a job half done, but it was half done in terms of we knew we could complete the second part of it.
It was all building up to that second leg and everything to play for at Taylor's Avenue.
Tonight's the night, Newry City can seal the ultimate comeback as they travel to Taylor's Avenue.
Darren Mullen's side travel to Carrick tonight for the second leg of the promotion playoff. They lead 3-2 from the first leg.
Can Newry City seal a dream return to the Premiership? They find out in just over 90 minutes' time. Darren Mullen's side takes a 3-2.
You sort of knew something was in the offing when I remember, I'll never forget, walking into the ground and hearing the Newry support singing about half an hour before kickoff, and it sounded like you were walking into a proper ground with a proper support. It sounded like there was thousands of us there.
That felt like, you know, the football that you watch and what you see in TV, in terms of that was a big occasion, and that was obviously a huge night for the club.
You always be nervous before a game. It's sort of part of it. It's part of the excitement of the game as well. You do be nervous, and I find nervous as a good thing. Like, you know, it sort of helped me sort of set myself before the game. And then I know when I walk out on the pitch, they usually just disappear. Maybe after the first kick of the ball or the first
first sort of touch of the ball you get, like, you know. I wasn't too down because obviously we've been there before, but seeing what they had, like, you know what I mean, just a bit disappointed with the way of it. It was free kick come in and free header, like, and I've maybe thought myself maybe I could have saved it, but I do that with most shots anyway. I think I should save everything, but obviously you can't, like, you know. But I wasn't too despondent at all. I thought that we still could push on, like, you know what I mean.
We knew they'd score at some point, so there wasn't any mass panic. It was just a case of right focusing, and when you have that experience and that cameras in the team, like, we had a load of experience, so there was nobody panicking within the group.
Again, there was never one bit of negativity from within the squad, from the sideline, from the fans. It was just, you know, complete positivity, and when you have that there, it's half the battle. So again, you know, one down, but we knew we had it in us to come back.
When the penalty was awarded, the sound, like, it was just, the atmosphere was electric. And it was probably one of the loudest moments off the night.
There's a penalty or not, I don't know.
I mean, there was nobody within 2 yards of him, and it was... It was a fantastic dive, to be fair. Because it's a penalty, you know, if it's somebody's had a shot from the edge of the box, you don't have time to sort of take that deep breath. When it's a penalty, you know, everybody sort of hushes before, so you have that time to prepare yourself and even get even more nervous. Goodness knows what Rambo must have felt like when he's stepping up to take the penalty.
Oh, I'm nervous as hell. Like, I am nervous as hell last days. I can't say I'm not. I don't really think I even watched that one either. I maybe did watch. I think I maybe sat down with my head down, maybe looking down at the ground, hands crossed and on my knees.
And then once that went in, again, like I said, game on.
Sort of what everybody felt was like, right, okay, we've got the upper hand again, let's not throw this away now, let's go and ram home our authority because we're the better team. Even when you're 5-3 up with about, I think maybe 15-20 minutes to go, you're still, you know, there's still nerves because they scored twice in 9 minutes, you know, in the first leg. So there's still nerves that you're going to, you know, something's going to happen or something's going to go against us. There's going to be something crazy is going to happen in the last 15, 20 minutes.
You're nearly running along with them when they're running through. You know, you're nearly running up until a point along with them.
I'm like, you better put this in, Mark. That's just the way I felt about it. Like, Cusie's a good mate of mine, and like off the pitch, like, and off the field, and I was telling you better score this year, like, you know.
Then I scored the winner, then sent us to the Premiership, then, you know. Oh, it was brilliant.
Once you see it hitting the back of the net, you can't buy emotion like that. It's super to see that in a game of that importance.
It's always nice to score for Newry, but it's extra special when it's to get us to the Premiership.
It was a long, long 90 minutes. I only really relaxed about 3 months ago on a turn and said to Barnsley, I think we'll have this here now. You know, I would never dare say something like that even anywhere forward, because anything can happen in football. But about 2 or 3 months ago, I said to Barnsley, I think we'll have it here.
At the end of the game, everyone's on the pitch, you know, hugging each other, and celebrations after was brilliant. Oh, it was absolutely brilliant. I would love to go back to that game now. Like, absolutely first class.
You're passing around everybody as well. Should it be family or friends, and you're hugging everybody, and you can see the emotion. It's great, and it's one of those ones you don't want to stop. That if you're taking back in time, that one there, it was terrific to see my family come down to it. Everybody else's family, and yet, no matter who you look around, there was hugs everywhere and tears. It's unreal. You know, and people have asked before what the secret is. There's no secret. We've just worked so hard. We have an honest bunch of players, and if you work hard, you get your rewards, and this is some reward for us. I'm getting interviewed on BBC after winning promotion to the Premiership. That, I always had that in my head. People say about positive visualisation. I had that in my head, thinking, right, okay, I'm going to get interviewed after it. And then to be interviewed that night, that was one surreal moment that night. It was just pure emotion. I was thinking, okay, don't cry here. Because you have my dad in the back of your head, you've the whole emotion of winning, and you're thinking, we've done it. We just worked so hard to get back to this level. That was the dream, to get back. And if someone said to me 5 years ago, you know, actually even starting getting interviewed here, that was the dream at the start, to be starting getting interviewed after getting back to the Premiership, and to be finally here is just unreal. I don't think I'll ever be beaten. No matter what happens, I don't think it'll ever be beaten in terms of emotion, because of it was part of that journey, if you like, 4 promotions in 5 years.
That's what you work hard for. All season, and just to hear that final whistle, you're just pure joy, hard to describe, I suppose. Yeah, delighted for everyone involved with the club, you know. Yeah, it's hard to describe it, but pure joy.
That night was a culmination of not that season's work, not just that season's work, it was a culmination of 5-6 years work from all the people behind the scenes. Not just that team that was on the pitch that night, not just the management that were there on the sidelines that night. It was everybody who had ever helped or put in £1 to £1,000 into the club, who had taken on a role. It was for them, they deserved it to be in the position we were, and to sort of bask in the glory, I suppose.
It was, the whole thing was a fairy tale. Going up each year was incredible, but to make that final step really was just the best moment in football that I've experienced.
I felt amazed that we could do something that we did. Like, you know, it was this achievement that I never thought I would ever see. As a kid, I never thought I'd see it. I was the Newry as a 17-year-old. It was amazing, and to do something like that is unbelievable. Like, you know, unbelievable feeling. Like.
Without doubt, probably the highlight of my career. Getting promoted with Newry.
It's time for Newry City, 'cause they're fucking dynamite. Oh!
That was when it sort of hit you that you're, you know, what you bring to these people, every Saturday they come down and support you, and this is what it means to them, the fact that they showed up on a Wednesday night after the game. So again, it just showed that connection.
The afternoon after the night before, and the party is still in full flow in Newry. Less than 6 years after going under, Newry City are back with the big boys in the top division of the Irish League.
It's special for myself, you know, I'm a proud Newry man, and to me this is my dream job, you know, managing my home city. My grandfather was a Newry fan, he used to take me down here when I was a kid, and my uncles all played for Newry, so to see the joy on the face last night, you know, my mother had about 40 candles lit in the house last night. I was just happy she didn't burn the house down.
Looking back on it, the memories of those playoffs, and especially the Carrick ones, it's going to take some beating. The celebrating after, you know, UTV coming down and the lads rolling down the hills, outside trainer's bar in the back of it. I've been completely selfish, you know, in terms of throwing myself into this club over the years, you know, missing stuff with my kids, you know, sacrificing nights out with my wife, the amount of time they put into it, you know, and Deanna's question is, are you sure it's worth it? Look at the stress you're putting yourself under. It's not all stressful, it's you know, it's a lot of it extremely joyful, but there is a huge amount of effort to do it. You know, I didn't throw myself in half-hearted.
Donegal Celtic, we're second and they're third. Do you think Daddy's team will win? What score?
14-0.
There's wee bits and pieces that night you're thinking back on about, you know, sorting out the constitution, ring, going to storm it, getting the kit changed because we couldn't buy a new one. Driving around with farms in the car, pulling in, going, well, who do we go now? Who can I go and sign? So all of that comes back, but it was worth it. I don't think you could ever have a greater reward than what that mean. If somebody offered me £1 million or that journey all day long.
We didn't feel sorry for ourselves. You know, there were no recriminations or blame. We just said, look, we'll take it in the chin and get back, try and get back to winning ways. And to do that in 5 years is a phenomenal achievement for everybody, both on and off the pitch.
I don't think anybody should ever underplay what we have done, considering the resources and what we had to put up with to do. It was a magnificent achievement, and it's only probably when you're older or when you look back on your career, you'll probably realise how it was. But that night, it was just the whole thing was just completely surreal.